Hello, I'm Graham Horton and welcome to today's video. A little departure from my usual photographic tutorials, today I've got a little electronic project for you which you might find useful. Now, this time of year, if you're anything like me and not my wife, we do like to have a few Christmas decorations around the house, and particularly in the garden I like to decorate the trees with LED lights. One part of the garden I'm particularly fortunate, as I've got a power supply there, I can put a weatherproof box and run quite a few power supplies from within that box. However, on the other side of the garden, I've got no local main supply, so it's difficult to get LED lighting there. So I've come up with a solution to that, and I think you might find that useful. Now, the traditional lights I'm talking about are these Christmas lights. Let me just turn those on and switch over to the onboard. Now, the power supplies for these units are generic Chinese models. They are 32 volts and 3.6 watts, or 6.2 on the 200 light sets. They're a standard 110 to 240 volt input, and again down to 32 volts. The static set just provide a 32 volt output. These multiplexes ones can be 32 volts, or they change polarity on the phases, so you can now see that just this satellite's on. As they change over, the polarity changes again. Now, the actual module inside these units, we've got the mains coming in here, we've got a switch mode power supply here, and then on the underside you can see the output stages, where we've got a little microprocessor to do the switching, and two p-channel MOSFETs and two n-channel MOSFETs, so we can actually switch over the polarity of the output to terminals. These are all 2Y devices, so if you're wondering how you can get multiple configurations on two wires, then that's how you do it. You switch over the plus and minus on each other supply rail. So quite a neat little unit. But the switch mode power supply, which is all this, converts from your AC input of 110 to 240 down to 32 volts on this side. So I come up with a simple solution to bypass all that but still use these units. So these at the moment are plugged into a 240 volt UK main supply. Put the two on the one adapter so I can show you that this device of mine will actually accommodate two units. So let me just turn those off for a moment. Remove the plug, just get rid of the mains adapter there. So my little unit is a cheap step-up converter. You can see I've got this marked for 38 volts, so the input is on this side and it can be anywhere from 5 to 15 volts, and the output can go from just slightly over your input voltage up to 40 volts on the output. So I've set this to 38 volts, which is normally within the range that these will operate at anyway. So 38 volts seems to be easily achievable, and that's done by adjusting this little potentiometer here, and that adjusts the output voltage. You've got a little display here which measures the input voltage. Press the button and it measures the output voltage, so you can actually see your input. If you're using this on a lithium-ion battery, that's useful because you can then see when it needs to be changed, when it's dropping towards 6.6 volts. Obviously the USB will stay at 5 volts and until the USB cuts out because of its internal limiting. So this is just a step-up converter going from normally 5 volts up to 38 volts. So let me first of all plug this into a lithium-ion power bank. This is a cycle headlamp battery, normally 8.2 volts, down to 6.6 when it's depleted. So let me just plug that in. And you can see that this is coming up to 39 volts, so normally 38 or 39 volts. So you can see I've attached on the output a standard UK socket. Now, it's not going to be mains voltage that's coming out of here, obviously. It's going to be the output from here, which is a nominal 38 volt DC. So let me plug in the double adapter so I can run the two sets of lights. Let me plug that in. I'm trying to get it into the shutter. Right. Tight on this particular unit for some reason. There we go. So now we've got the coloured lights powered up, and fractionally behind that we've got the static lights. So it's providing 38 volts. Each one is taking about 0.3 of an amp on the input, so it's not going to stress the lithium ion cell or even your power bank. And this unit will actually quite happily run to towards 3 or 4 amps without cooling. If you wanted to increase that, then you just put a little heatsink on this device, which is the regulator itself. So that's all that would be needed to be done. If you needed to increase the cooling. Now this is going to be outside in winter, so it's going to be cooled by this ambient temperature, so I'm not worried about the heat of this unit. But at the moment you can see this is being powered from this cycle battery at 8.4 volts. If I just disconnect the cycle battery, so let me plug in my adapter which allows me to use my USB power bank. I'm going to start off with a small one. This is a 8,000 milliamp hour, so when you do the conversion that's about 6,000 milliamp hours in total capacity. And again, this is up to 2.1 amp output, so let me plug that in. And you see the voltage has come back up to 38, and you can see both the units have powered up. So this power bank up to 2.1 amps can actually supply the current needed to run two of these light sets. But obviously this is only going to run for between 12 and 14 hours, I guess. So if I change this for a heavier duty power bank, and here I've got one which is rated at 20,000 milliamp hour, so again doing the conversion, that's about 16,000 milliamp hour. So this should give me a couple of days running on a power bank, which is more than adequate, and I'll just swap it out when I see the percentage dropping to about 15%. I'll just swap out the power bank. So this is that step up module again, from 5 up to 15 volts on the input. And you can set this to nominally 38 or 39 volts to power these two modules. So all that needs to be done is to put this into a weatherproof box, to a Tupperware disc or something like that, to protect the device and the two outputs if I'm going to run the two light sets, and put the power supply or the cycle battery in there. So there we are, a simple step-up converter which will convert your power bank at 5 volts up to 38 volts to run your Christmas LED lights safely without fear of electrocution in your garden. So I hope you found that useful. In 2022 I'm going to be running a few little electronics projects. I think you might find some of them quite interesting. I'm trying to kind of keep them with a photographic interest, so if you are into photography and can do a bit of electronics DIY, then you may want to follow along. So if you're not already subscribed to this channel, why not hit that subscribe button and the bell notification icon, and you'll be advised when I upload new videos to the channel. So there we are. If you hit the like button, if you did like the video, I'd be truly appreciative, as that will help to get the algorithms working to push me towards that magic 100k subscribers, which I'd dearly love to reach in 2022. So that's all for this video. I hope you did find it useful, and I hope to see you all very, very soon.